The ethylene gas released by the ripe banana will soon turn the tomatoes red.
Climbers like roses and clematis need to be tied in before autumn winds damage the stems. Replace any wires or strings that the plants have outgrown and double loop the string around the support so that the tie doesn't cut into the plant.
One more thing. Don't forget to support your melons. Now these have been swelling nicely on these melon vines for the last month or so. And they're getting so heavy that the stems aren't able to support their own weight. So the trick is to make a little sack or girdle for them. And then tie it up to the roof of the greenhouse just to support the weight. Now I'll know when these melons are ready because the greenhouse will be filled with their ambrosial scent and accompanied by a little nectar-like drop of sap at the base. And it'll be ripe and ready for the picking. Hopefully by next week. And I'll see you next week too. Until then, enjoy your garden.
The experiences of a daredevil helicopter pilot on active service, captured on his own camera. The Home Movie Roadshow is next on BBC Two.
We are out here because boys are not doing as well as the girls.
Can Gareth Malone get our schoolboys back on track?
We're going to change school. I will make it as fun, as exciting, sometimes as dangerous as I possibly can.
I think there is a better way of doing things, a way that is more dynamic.
If school feels like a place where boys can take risks, then they'll be more engaged.
Gareth Malone's Extraordinary School for Boys, part of school season, starts Thursday at 9 on BBC Two.
Hello, Peggy. Once,
twice.
Let me look at you.
Oh! You deserve all this, did I?
I haven't even started yet.
Now, where was I?
Yes, you were.
Oh, yeah.
Dwayne.
I'm not even starting,
no! I don't think you know who you're dealing with here.
It's last orders for the nation's favourite landlady.
Hope you all enjoyed the fireworks.
Good night.
EastEnders all next week on BBC One.
More of your stories filmed by you now on BBC Two. It's the Home Movie Roadshow.
If you thought shooting video yourself and showing it on YouTube was a new thing, you'd be wrong. For 100 years, the British have filmed their own lives on their own cameras. And what four generations have shot tells a totally different story than all the official film. It's buried treasure, lying unseen, forgotten in thousands of attics and top drawers. A priceless archive that must be saved. This is 100 years of Britain's home movies.
When we asked you to send us your home movie footage, we never imagined you would find such an enormous amount of material. It shows us how much of our lives we have in common. Our film historians, Robin and Binnie, worked with us to bring this unseen archive to life.
Our expert team has been unearthing the stories behind your home movies and searching the archives for films that tell our history from a personal perspective. Binnie Baker is an archivist at the Yorkshire Film Archive. She's passionate about using amateur footage as a primary source of social history.
Film deteriorates continually, and unless it's preserved, it goes, it's gone. We have to collect it and save it. It is the nation's heritage.
As head curator at the British Film Institute, Robin Baker is an enthusiastic champion of home movies as a very special part of Britain's film history.
Most people, if you say what is the most important thing that you own, it would probably be photographs of family. Yet home movies are actually your family moving, so the kind of closest you get to that real embodiment of what they're like. So to lose that record seems really sad to me.
These are the home movies that we'll be showing you tonight. Vinny goes to investigate a piece of medical history and reunites a group of women with a record of their youth.
Where's you? Where?
In the middle there.
Robin meets a daring helicopter pilot who filmed his experience on active service in Southeast Asia.
Landing a helicopter into this very small clearing in that heat was very difficult.
And we revisit some of the places we've been to in our home movie cinebus and meet a man who hung out on the King's Road in London in 1978, filming a record of punk.
The first afternoon I did it, I was absolutely frightened. I thought, well, you know, I'm going to get beaten up here, but I have to do it.
Some of the most intriguing home movies are those which are ostensibly just a record of a single family. But in filming their own lives, they capture significant social and economic change. Robin's been to see one such collection.
The Arcady estate in Perthshire has been owned by the Bowser family since 1916. In the 1920s, David Charles Bowser invested in a 16mm cine camera and shot his first scenes of estate life. During his lifetime, he recorded the work of the family farm, from ploughing contests to making hay. His passion for filmmaking was passed on to his son. The collection they created charts huge changes in the rural way of life right up to the 1960s.
Seeing materials early as the late 1920s is relatively unusual in home movies, but also to see this kind of complete history, really, a kind of social history of this area of Scotland over 50, 60 years.
Yes, if you'd like to tell us about any films you think are special, then do contact us at the address below. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
If you've missed any of the home movie roadshows, you can catch up now on BBC iPlayer. You can almost feel the embarrassment. Next here on BBC Two, you'll cringe as Roger and Val have just got in.
On the review show later, we'll be exploring the jump cut from the comic strip to the cinema screen with Stephen Frears' satire Tamara Drew and DC Comics' Jonah Hex. Oh, and DBC Pierre is back.